more time. No. Keep it going. Smile, Taryn. Taryn, come on. This is supposed to be springtime in New York. Expectations, perfume. You look like a corpse.
My lips are blue because I'm freezing to death, Ollie. I want some hot chocolate. Now.
Taryn, we've got 5 more setups to do, and we're 3 hours behind.
Oh, Taryn, darling, why don't you start working a little harder for Oliver, and then it'll all be over. All right, let me get you some hot tea, some hot milk.
Over here, Taryn.
Oh. If I put on any more concealer, she'll be doing mime in Central Park. 16-year-old sleep anymore, sweetheart?
I don't look so bad, Connie. I'm just tired of standing around half-dressed in 30-degree weather.
If you really want to get warmed up, honey buns, here's Wesley.
Hello, my sweet. Come talk to me, all right? Excuse us.
Wow, I wish we lived here instead of Stonehurst.
Ah, me too.
I don't feel so tall in New York.
Yeah, me neither.
Gareth, look over there. Is that who I think it is, or am I hallucinating?
Look, they're filming a movie or something. No, it's a model. Oh, Mom, can we go look?
Oh, come on, we have to get you some clothes.
Oh, come on, let's go.
Dinah Anderson!
Dinah! Connie! Dinah. Gareth!
Dinah!
Oh, God! Look at you! See you! You look wonderful! I love the beard.
Thank you.
Oh, it's so good to see you both.
Where have you been? We thought you'd gone back to your ex-husband or something. And the baby! How's the baby? She must be in school by now, or what?
Meet the baby?
God!
Lori, what you mean, Conrad and Gareth? We worked together at Macy's when you were... Oh, my God, it's been 12 years.
Yeah, shut up. Does she talk yet?
Maybe if we let her.
Oh, I've got an idea. Hey, Oliver, come here, take pictures for us.
Come here, all right. Yeah, Oliver, come on.
Come here. We'll have something.
Now, here, this way. The dying sound.
The drama. Don't disappear on us again.
I won't put up with this anymore, Julia.
She's just overtired, Wesley. You know how they are when they're 16?
I haven't the faintest idea of how they are, Julia.
Well, she's tired.
But I got a very good idea of the money that Harper Cosmetics has invested in your daughter.
And she's made plenty for you in return.
And if you don't exercise a little control over your daughter, I will be forced to make other arrangements.
This is Wesley Harper. I want to talk to Racine.
Sure. Hold on one moment. Wesley Harper's on two, steaming.
I don't want to hear another word about Taryn Blake. Just tell him I'll call him back, all right? I'm out. I'm just out. Now, I simply do not understand why that husband of yours feels the need to find a model for his new sports line when he has you right under his nose, Blair.
David wants a fresh face for the new line receipt. Somebody young, unknown.
Darling, you are going to adore being 30.
Only if I can look as good as you.
Oh, nonsense, Blair. The new Audrey Hepburn, that's what they called you. Seems like just yesterday. You were my first client. And, honey, you still have the best cheekbones in the business. I am just going to have a talk with that husband of yours.
Don't talk to David, Racine.
Please. All right. I just hope he realizes you're simply not ready to settle down and have half a dozen babies. Well, I don't know. Not working as much as I used to. Oh, don't be silly, Blair. That layout in Italian Vogue, 6 pages, and the Narducci collection in the fall.
They've confirmed?
Well, no, they haven't exactly confirmed, but you know Gianni adores you. He wouldn't dream of using anybody but you. I only wish Taryn Blake had 1 ounce of your professionalism.
Oh. Poor Taryn. It's gotta be tough having Julia for a mother.
Every booking that child has had lately has been a disaster.
Is that what Wesley was calling you about?
Oh, yes. Your poor, dear stepbrother under such pressure working for your father. And, of course, Taryn is to blame. I rather think I'm going to have to do something about that young lady.
Something else.
Mr. Harper, will you be needing me before noon?
No, I don't think so, Scotty. Thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Harper, thank you so much for the flowers.
Thank you for your confidence in the company, Rosemary. You keep buying our stock. You'll retire before I do. Morning, Anna.
Good morning, Mr. Harper.
Thank you. I'll go over these calls with you after the meeting with Wesley, huh? Would you call my wife, please? Tell her that I'll be home around 7 this evening.
Yes, Mr. Harper. Should I tell your son to come in now?
Yes, have him come in.
You wanted to see me?
Sit down, Wesley. Coffee?
No, thank you.
I'm disappointed with the latest sales figures for Harper Cosmetics. You're spending a great deal of money, and the return is only a fraction of what it should be.
Yeah, but expectations is a new line. I mean, it takes a while to build up sales.
You've had more than enough time. Now, what's the problem?
I'll tell you what the problem is. The problem is Taryn Blake. Number one, she is impossible to deal with. She is temperamental, and she is a prima donna.
She's a 16-year-old girl.
She is a monster, is what she is. She doesn't show up on time. She doesn't work when she gets there. She's getting a lot of bad publicity, and it's rubbing off on every one of our products.
When I gave you the cosmetics company to run, I thought you said you could handle it.
If her mother can't control her, how the hell am I supposed to control her? I spend half my time running to and from locations, and I...
You said you could handle it. Handle it, Wesley. Blair's birthday party's on Sunday. Your mother would like you to join us beforehand for drinks.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't do that. I have other plans. And she's my stepmother. My mother's dead. Remember?
How can one 16-year-old brat create such chaos? And you bring me another one.
But she's different. She's a natural. And she's a real kid.
Oh, God, save me from any model under the age of 20. Well, 18. Oliver, Laurie Caswell, She's very sweet, but really nothing special.
Racine, trust me. She's a 9 without even trying. Take a look at that face.
It's just I'm not sure it's the right thing, Michael. It's all the wrong values. Do you think that looks are the only thing that count?
I will not!
Lori, I know it seems very glamorous, but it isn't. Modeling is hard work. What's smiling when you feel rotten? And wearing furs in a heat wave and bikinis in the snow. And it's never eating ice cream again. But worst of all, it's being treated like a piece of meat.
Dinah, don't you think you're overdoing it? And if the woman sees something in Lori...
I don't need a model's agent to tell me I have a beautiful daughter.
Well, maybe I do.
Well, then I'd say you had a problem.
Will you two knock it off?
It's easy for you, Mom. All you have to do is look in the mirror. You never had anyone call you giraffe in school.
Why do you keep putting yourself down?
I don't think it's fair. You won't even let me see her.
What do you think, Michael?
Well, do you want me to play wicked stepfather or tell you what I really think? Dinah, the woman wants to meet her. You know, it's not as though we're selling her into white slavery. You know, probably nothing will come of this. Those agencies must see 100 kids a day.
I know, but she's my kid. Now, she's just a baby, and she's so wonderful. Why doesn't she see it?
Let her go, Dinah. Maybe she'll find out for herself.
Sarah, will you look? There is a line. I tell you, I'm getting crow's feet.
Oh, please. I've been looking for lines in your face through 4 presidencies, Blair Fenton, and I haven't seen one yet. You look exactly the same as the day that I met you. Remember in that horrible room at Bryn Mawr?
Well, I didn't think it was such a bad room. Actually, I kind of miss it.
That's easy for you to say now. Oh, there's David. I will leave you to show your wrinkles to him, dear.
Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Hi. Hi, Sarah.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi. Oh, the sexiest neck in New York.
David.
Mm-hmm.
David.
Oh, you're looking good, Sarah.
Thank you.
And how's everything down at the DA's office?
Oh, just fine.
Wonderful. Any exotic crimes to report?
You know, I would say that you have an unhealthy interest in exotic crimes, Mr. Fenton. I'm going to be keeping an eye on you.
Yes.
Blair, I'll see you at exercise class.
Bye.
Night.
Bye.
I feel like going now.
Bless you.
Hold on, Val. Wait a minute. Now, listen, don't get any ideas. We have to be at Diana's in 1 hour.
Well, I was thinking maybe we could skip Diana's party tonight and just, you know, stay home, pop some popcorn, and practice making babies.
No way, Jose. No way. You'll get the popcorn, and I'll get the baby.
All right, tell you what. I'll make you a deal. You carry the kid. I'll do the morning sickness. What do you say?
No deal. David, I do want children, really. Only not now. I just need some more time, okay? Please?
Yeah.
I don't have any friends my own age. I never go anywhere, unless you go too. I want a normal life, ride the subway and go to school.
Be a regular kid and go out for cheerleader, is that it? You wouldn't know where to start, honey.
That's your fault, it's not mine.
You think you got to be Taryn Blake by some kind of miracle? I rode plenty of subways to get you where you are. I took you from diaper ads to baby powder commercials to catalog work to magazine covers. I made you the most famous 16-year-old girl in the world.
But I don't want to be famous.
But you are.
I just want to be normal.
What's wrong, darling? Why don't you tell me what's really bothering you? Hmm? Tell me. Don't you think I know what it's cost you? But you are the best. The best there ever was, and the best there ever will be. But I want you to be happy, too.
Oh, Mommy. I'm sorry, Mommy.
Sorry? You don't have to be sorry.
I'm just so scared.
Scared? What are you scared of? What are you
scared? I feel like I'm all alone.
Alone? What, are you crazy? You're not alone. You've got me. You've got me all the way, kiddo. All the way.
So you're Laurie Caswell. Lovely, quite lovely. Nice bone structure. Eyes. How tall are you, dear?
5'11".
Weight, honestly?
125.
Better cut down on the fries and no more ice cream, all right? Laurie, dear, would you mind waiting outside while I talk to your mother? Thank you. Well, I don't have to tell you. She's really quite spectacular.
The happy hour is back.
Depression is not an excuse.
Kelly doesn't do ads with Cass. She's allergic. Hold on.
Jim Palmer shaved his head. Look, I seriously doubt it.
Hello,
dear. Is Racine busy?
Yes, she's in the meeting right now.
Well, I need to see her just for a short time, so if you don't mind, I'd like to go in there. Taryn, why don't you go and sit over there, darling, and try to stay out of trouble for 5 minutes?
Mrs. Blake, let me get you a cup of coffee.
She's doing very well in high school, and I'm very concerned.
Racine,
I have to talk to you about Wesley Harper.
Julia, darling, I am in a meeting.
Well, I can see that. Excuse me. Yours?
Yes. My daughter.
She's a natural. Don't you think, Julia?
Yes. She'll do quite well, if she has the stamina.
Oh, she'll do very well, thank you. Very well indeed. Yes, I think this afternoon will be fine to do the test shots.
Well, I guess my meeting is over. Thank you, Julia.
You're Taryn Blake!
I am. Good grief.
Oh, I'm sorry, that was really dumb. It's just such a shock having you sit right here. My name's Laurie Caswell.
How nice for you.
Robert, good to see you. Trust me, the women of Wichita will thank you from the bottom of their charge plate. Gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
See you later, Dave.
Bye-bye. Thanks.
It's not. I don't care what your weekend plans are. I want the boys at my apartment 10 a.m. Saturday.
So, Denise giving you a hard time?
What else?
Uh-huh.
First, there was more child support. The judge threw that out. Now she's got another judge. She's going after more alimony.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, the other news is that we're up to our necks in orders for the spring line.
Ah, this is great. This is wonderful. What? This is not great. This is not wonderful. What?
David, we're out of money. We've used all the capital we had.
So we go to the bank.
We've been to the bank. Don't you... David, remember, we talked about this. You borrow money from the bank, there comes a day, you gotta pay it back. We can't make the interest payments, let alone the notes.
Nick! You'll think of something. You always do.
Don't worry. Well, wait, what about Marty Brickman?
Marty Brickman?
From the neighborhood, Marty Brickman. Yeah.
Are you crazy? No, Marty is bad news.
Maybe I can stall the banks with the ad campaign, but when am I going to get the ad campaign?
Nick, I haven't found the girl yet. Zoli's got someone that I like, but Racine said I should call back. So did Eileen. Look, Nick, I want to find someone new, you know? Fresh face. Huh? Okay, look, I got to have lunch with some guy from People Magazine. Why don't you join us?
They don't want the business partner, buddy. You're the hotshot designer.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Wait, David. David, come here.
I think it's time we talk with Grant Harper.
His money is as good as anyone else's.
No, I would rather do business with Marty Brickman.
Remember when we first bought this place, you said, I'm going to be a horse trainer when I grow up. Remember saying that down there at the stables? Yeah, I made a damn good one, too.
Well, one thing about training horses, it's supposed to get better as you get older.
Hey, you're not worried about getting older, are you? Ah, Princess, you're still the most beautiful girl in the world.
Oh, Daddy, I'm almost 30 years old.
Not to me. You'll always be my little girl. I was thinking about your 10th birthday. The circus in our garden at Foxtown, huh?
Oh, yeah. You know which was my favorite? When you had the beach party. And two of the gardeners ended up quitting because they couldn't get all stand off the lawn.
Yeah.
How old was I then?
Sweet 16. You know, I'd love to be able to do something special for you this year, but I don't know, David, he'd rather have your party at the apartment, huh?
Yeah.
Sweetheart, something bothering you?
Oh, I guess David a little. You know, he works so hard and, well, he tells me everything with the business is great, but I know he's worried.
I've told you a dozen times. If David needs advice, money, whatever, all he has to do is ask.
Yeah, and I've told you a dozen times that he'll never take a nickel from you. You know how independent he is. I think that's why you like him.
Well, I don't ever remember saying I like David, the guy who took away my favorite girl. Must be your mother who likes him.
Yeah, it must be.
Your mother. We're supposed to be having lunch with her.
You're right.
Race you back to stables.
How much?
$20.
You're on.
Okay.
Here with no coat on.
I'm just looking. Sometimes I forget how beautiful it is here. Hello, Blair.
Where's your father?
Oh, he'll be here in a minute. Did you get your hair done?
This morning. Do you like it?
Oh, it looks beautiful. Mom, you always look beautiful.
There he is now.
All right, I'm gonna go get cleaned up.
Oh, darling. Make sure that the salmon isn't overchilled. Will you please tell Janet?
Mother, she's only been making this for the past 20 years.
Grant?
Ah, Marjorie, you look lovely. Yeah?
My favorites. White roses. Thank you. You are so thoughtful.
Well, if you come home for lunch more often. What do you get for lunch, huh?
Chilled salmon.
Stop looking so nervous, Di. She's gorgeous.
Yes, but does she have the stamina?
Who needs stamina when you've got skin like this?
How much makeup do I have on?
Oh, a ton. I'm surprised your face hasn't fallen off yet.
I guess I really needed help. Huh?
Oh, yeah. That's good. Okay. Now for a little magic dust. Okay, Gareth, finish her off. But keep it simple.
Darling, how are you? Oh, yes, I heard you're having a terrible time finding a model. Well, I promised myself I wouldn't call you until I had absolutely the perfect girl. So, David, I'm calling.
I'd like to limit her work time. At least until after school's out, Racine, and then she could work more during vacation, of course.
Of course.
Oh, I'm not finished yet.
Oh, yes, you are, dear.
I think it's wonderful that you're concerned. It's too easy for these kids to be exploited.
How do you get so damn lucky, Fenton?
Ah, John, good to see you.
Three most beautiful women in the room. Oh, Racine, I didn't recognize you. And this is...
Dinah, meet Jonathan Westfield.
And then run like hell. Hello, John. Written any bad books lately?
None that you're likely to have read, Racine. Dinah...
Caswell. Good to meet you.
And this is little Laurie, Dinah's daughter.
Hi.
Well, I'm an hour late for my publisher. David, I'll see you on Sunday.
I hope so.
I hope we meet again, Dinah Caswell. And for the Divine Jaws 4.
Dearest John, the proverbial good time that's been had by all. Oh, I would love some more tea, thank you.
Dinah, are you and your husband doing anything on Sunday evening?
No, I don't think so.
Then please, come to my wife's birthday party. You too, little Laurie. We might as well get to know each other.
That would be lovely.
You ever been to California?
I wish.
Your wish is but my command. You and your mother can start packing. We leave for L.A. on Monday, shoot the spring, lay out at UCLA on Tuesday, and I will have you back in New York in time for dinner Wednesday evening. What do you say?
All right. I think that's wonderful.
David is always so stimulating, so full of surprises.
Ah, yes.
Oh, you cannot imagine what a boring lunch I had today. God, do I love with Chinese food. One is never quite sure what one is eating.
Don't change the subject, Racine. You
are the one that talked us into using Taryn Blake.
Talked you into using the number one model in the world? Oh, darling, don't be silly. You were lucky to get her.
Racine, for God's sake, I am in big trouble. Find me somebody else.
Of course I will, darling. Taryn Blake is not the only girl in town, you know.
Oh, dear, dear Racine. What would I do without you?
Exactly.
Wonderful party ever.
Come on.
Okay. Thank you for this.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Happy birthday, Princess.
Thanks, Daddy. Oh, Daddy, this is gorgeous.
This one's just for you, Blair.
Thanks, Bobby.
May I, sweetheart?
You are my lucky star. I saw.
Those are from the Cellini collection. I saw the exhibit at the Metropolitan.
Yeah, we should all be grateful Venice isn't for sale.
Blair Fenton, let me see that. Come here.
Okay.
Come on over.
Oh, my God. Get me over here. I don't believe it. Oh, no.
Charming. You will excuse me, Wesley.
You are my Shearer, Crawford, Hepburn, Harlow, and my Garbo. You are my lucky star.
All right.
There's Wesley Harper. Go and talk to him. And be charming.
I don't like Wesley Harper, Mommy.
Well, he doesn't have to know that.
What's she doing?
Valentine's Day. It's coming right up, you know.
As far as I... Hi. Dinah, I'm so glad you could make it.
Thank you.
And you, are you all ready for Malibu and palm trees and movie stars?
Do I get to meet Tom Cruise?
Yes.
It's okay.
So many tubs.
Hi, how are you?
Sarah.
Hi.
And how is the president of the John Westfield Fan Club?
I don't know. Is she here tonight? How are you, John?
Looking for someone I just found. Excuse me.
Excellent.
I thought I'd never find you again. Why aren't you listed in the Manhattan Directory?
Because I don't live in Manhattan. Hello, Jonathan.
Not New Jersey. Anywhere but New Jersey.
David?
Not New Jersey.
Hear good things about the orders in the spring line. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I also ran into Jim Conley. He tells me that you want to renew your loans at the bank. Now, David, why won't you come to me?
Well, thanks, Grant, but
I prefer to pay the bank's kind of interest.
Problems, David? Ah, let Daddy help.
You're drunk, Wesley.
Yes, working on it. Ah, there she is, the bane of my poor existence.
Taryn, have you met Laura Caswell?
Sure. Wesley.
Julia.
Have you said hello to Taryn?
No, I haven't.
Well, let me get her for you.
Great.
Taryn!
There's my mother. Quick, come with me.
Taryn, I guess she didn't hear me.
I guess I was kind of rude the other day.
Oh, no,
sorry,
really.
About that. I just don't get to meet a whole bunch of people my own age. Damn, I'm out. You got any Coke?
No, I don't do that kind of stuff.
Listen, do you want to go to a real party? Timmy Doyle and his band are staying at the Plaza, and I'm invited. You could come, too.
My parents would freak.
So, come on. Timmy's intense. It'll be outrageous, huh? Whatever. But cover for me, okay? I mean, don't tell anyone where I'm going. Especially my mother.
Okay.
You stepped out of a dream.
No, but I was talking about her the other day, and when we ran across her, she was just... Sorry.
Could there be eyes?
Where on Long Island do you live?
Could there be smiles?
Welcome to life in the fast lane.
Yeah.
Well, she likes to bathe.
No, relax.
Looking good.
Yeah, you too.
You're running the 10K meet next week?
No, no, not me.
Oh, come on. You can handle it.
I sponsor them. I don't run it.
What would happen if we followed you?
Not much.
Grant.
Oh, Grant.
Yeah. Thank you, Maria. Your car is here. We were up so late last night. I thought you might stay and relax a little this morning.
I thought you'd exhaust me with your wicked ways, huh?
Well, not totally exhausted, I hope.
Hello, I'm Taylor Marsh with our weekly commentary. Today's big story is, of course, the arrest last night of child model Taryn Blake for drug possession. Despite the strict child labor laws we have today, there is still a subtle cruelty perpetrated on child actors and child models. How destructive it must be for a teenage child to see herself like this.
Oh, I can't stand that woman. She'll do anything to get attention.
Everything. And the images are getting younger every year. Now we have reached a new low with Taryn Blake and Expectations Perfume, the latest product from the cosmetics division of Harper Worldwide Incorporated. Chairman Grant Harper, we are told, is a private man, deeply devoted to his wife and children. One wonders if Mr. Harper feels any responsibility for what happened last night to a 16-year-old child. I'll have more next week on the rise and fall of supermodel Taryn Blake. This is Taylor Marshall.
Grant, it's just sensationalism. Muckraking.
That's why I prefer watching Good Morning America. This is Grant Harper. Put me through to my son, please. Blair's been modeling since she was in school. Am I supposed to have exploited her, too?
Cute boys, catty girls, and lots of fooling around.
Pull back up into our lunges. Here we go. To the right. Stretch to the left. Again. Right. One more time. Left. Take to the center. Around the back. Here we go. Pull it up slowly. Here we go. Up. Reach right. Two more. Still working. Right. Come on, center. Put your back into it. Here we go. Right. Left. Bring it out to the front. Final movement. Stretch. Come on. Eight more. If Sarah's messing up. Here we go. Seven. Reach. Six. Five. Four. Reach. Come on. Three. Good. Stretch. One more. And that's it. And wrap it. That's it. Good job. Good job. Shake it out a little bit. It's better.
Oh. Why am I doing this to my body?
I love my body.
Come on, Sarah, you can handle it.
Oh, sure.
Blair, you okay? Now, listen, you two, I gotta run. I'm late for another appointment, but I'll see you next week.
Okay, thanks.
Take care of the bodies.
Oh. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I think I prefer working out at the health club. At least there I can hide in the back row. Blair? Here, come here. Here, sit down right here. Sit down. Put your head between your knees. Take deep breaths. You okay, sweetie? I'll get you some water.
No, no, I'm all right, really. Oh, I just got dizzy there for a moment.
Don't you think killing yourself to stay in shape is overdoing things a little bit? So how much did you have to drink last night, anyway?
Probably too much. Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't eat any breakfast either. David left for L.A. at 6 o'clock this morning.
Oh,
did you have fun last night?
Uh-huh.
I saw you and Nick with your heads together.
Oh, will you stop matchmaking? Oh, let me see the rock. I couldn't get close enough to see it last night. Oh, it's gorgeous.
I know. I love it. Did you see my necklace?
Oh, I also saw the look on David's face when your father gave it to you.
Sarah, I'm gonna take a shower. Oh.
Blair. Honey, since when do you get dizzy like this?
I don't know. A couple of times in the last week.
Are you by any chance, late?
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 Why?
Well, I think you better call Dr. Van Adams. Today.
I'm all right. Okay?
Today. Huh? Oh, you're all right.
Yeah.
That remains to be seen.
I think you better take a shower first, because you're going to be late for work.
I think you better call the doctor.
Bye.
Bye. Will you do that? Just give him a call? You think about it.
What do you think this is, Julia? Some game that we're playing with your drugged-out daughter? You're in breach of contract.
Is that a legal opinion, Wesley, or just some advice you picked up at Elaine's?
That is Clause 18, Section 5, the Morals Clause, sweetheart, in case you've forgotten.
If you believe everything you read in the newspapers about Taryn, you're in the wrong business.
Oh, really?
Our contract has a year to run. And the option to renew is ours. Am I correct?
It is a good deal.
Option to renew what? Contractually, I am entitled to drop Taryn Blake from all future promotion and hire a new model, which is exactly what I intend to do.
You just try it, Wesley. You just go on and try it. I'll bring suit against Harper Cosmetics for ruining Taryn's career. And it'll cost you every cent you've got.
Threats of lawsuits are pointless, and it's not why we're here.
Oh, I agree with you, Grant.
Why are we here?
Tara needs a rest. She's 16 years old, and she works harder than most adults. I'm prepared to arrange a 6-month suspension from her contract. And I'd suggest she take some time out from her other commitments as well, Julia. Take her away somewhere. Let her relax. Welcome to use my house in Nassau, if you like.
That's very generous of you, Grant.
How divine! A 6-month paid vacation for Taryn. And she will still be on retainer, of course.
You won't lose your commission, Missy.
I assume you'll keep the press out of this.
My people will give them a statement. She's exhausted.
Poor baby.
Given so much of herself. We've all made too many demands on her. Now, don't you worry. I'll take care of the media.
I'm so glad we could resolve this silly little problem.
Goodbye, Grant.
Goodbye.
Helena, give me Taylor Marsh, please.
Yes, sir.
Soapnet original that puts the stars in the hot seat.
unpredictable, unbeatable, and sometimes unbelievable. Lisa Rinna and Ty Treadway dish with the celebs on the Emmy-nominated Soap Talk. Tonight at 11 on SoapNet.